Hello friends, welcome to EduTap. I welcome you all in the rapid session of general awareness and we'll be discussing the most important current affairs from 11th to 13th of June 2021. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and join our Telegram channel for the free data and the notification of the session. The content which we are providing you is really very, very helpful for our examination friends. We are providing you daily exam booster of general awareness, ESI current affair, report and indices. Now, superstar of the session are Ganesh, Neil, Dinupriya, Nilesh, Suryavanshi, who have given the right answer to the homework question below my video. And thank you so much, friends, for replying over there. Now, question number one says, friends, Dhingpat Kai has become the 7th national park of Dash and Assam. Option number C is the right answer to this question. Let's discuss, let's play with the option. All the national park with the name Shola belongs to Kerala. Annamudi Shola, Mathiketan Shola, Pampadum Shola, Iravikulam, Periyar and Silent Valley National Park. If I talk about Madhya Pradesh, then Bandhavgarh, Madhav, Panna, Pench, Satpura, Vanbihar, Fossil, Kuno and Kanha are the National Park of Madhya Pradesh. If we talk about Rajasthan, friends, then all the National Parks of Rajasthan are your Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary, that is Kevla Dev National Park, Sariska Tiger Reserve, Desert and Daraha National Park. Next is, friends, Tamil Nadu. If we talk about Tamil Nadu, friends, the National Park of Tamil Nadu are with the name Malai. That is Annamalai, your Mudhumalai, your Mukurthi, Gundi, Gulf of Mannar National Park. Okay, friends. So, these are the national parks. Now, friends, your Dhingpat Kai, friends, which is basically, which covers an area of 234.26 square kilometers, okay, has added as the 7th national park of Assam. Now, we have discussed in the previous video that recently 6th national park of Assam was also added in the list, that was Raimona. Now one more is added and total 7 national parks are present in your Assam. If I talk about other national park, those are, friends, your Dibru Saikova, Manas, Nameri, Orang, Kaziranga and your Raimona. And now one more added, that is your Dhingpat Kai, are all the national park of your Assam. Remember this. Friends, small stretches of Dirak and Buri Dhing rivers are also included in this national park. The maximum national park are present in Madhya Pradesh. Second number is for Andaman Nicobar Islands and third is for Assam, containing 7 national parks. Now, if I talk about National Park of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, friends, then it is Campbell Bay, Getha Bay, okay. Next is your North Button, Middle Button, South Button, Saddle Peak. Then is from, friends, Rani Jhansi National Park, then your Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park and Mount Harriet National Park are the national park which are present in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So question number two, friends, which of the following bank has been named by Forbes in their list of World Best Bank 2021? So the right answer to this question is DBS Bank. Now, friends, here HDFC Bank is given and we can relate many things with HDFC Bank. Let's play with the option. HDFC Bank, friends. Point number one. HDFC Bank. Recently, RBI has appointed, Atanu Chakraborty as the part-time chairman of your HDFC Bank. I hope you remember. Then, friends, RBI has imposed a penalty of rupees 10 crore rupees on HDFC Bank for irregularities found in its auto loan book. I hope you remember this also. I have discussed this news with you. Next, friends, HDFC Bank have launched and Chatbot Eva for village level entrepreneurs, basically to strengthen their business on this platform. They can discuss, take knowledge regarding to loan, investment, etc. And friends, one more important thing, that HDFC have recently announced that they will become carbon neutral by 2031 to 2032. I hope you remember all these things. I have discussed each and every news with you within the video. This is just we are revising and connecting everything. Now, friends, DBS has named by Forbes in the World Best Banks 2021 list. Friends, it has ranked first out of 30 domestic and your international bank in India, and it has been ranked first for the second consecutive year. Okay, remember this, DBS can be asked in your examination. Now, friends, the third edition of World Best Bank by Forbes has been conducted in the partnership of Statista. Okay, within partnership of Statista, friends, and DBS India has recognized India's best international bank for 2021 by your Asia Money. Now, take before the examination, MD and CEO of DBS Bank is your Sujit Shom. I hope, friends, this is clear to you. Question number three. RBI has approved the reappointment of Dash as the part-time chairman of ICICI Bank. Now, friends, with this part-time chairman, we can remember HDFC's part-time chairman. That is Atanu Chakraborty. I have recently discussed it and done in previous videos also. So, the right answer to this question is option number C, friends. That is Girish Chandra Chaturvedi is the right answer, who has been reappointed as the part-time chairman of ICICI Bank. Now, friends, it's time to play with the options. Now, Anoop Chandra Pandey is there in the option. It has been appointed as the election commissioner by Election Commission of India. I hope you remember, discussed in the previous video. Vishwaveer Ahuja, friends, has been appointed as the MD and CEO of your RBL Bank. If I talk about Hitendra Dev, friends, he has been appointed as the CEO of HSBC Bank. Headquarters of HSBC Bank are in London. If I talk about Dr. Patrick Amoth, then friends, he has been appointed as the chairman of WHO World Health Organization. Headquarters are in Geneva, Switzerland. And with this Switzerland, I remember International Hockey Federation's headquarters are also present in Switzerland. I hope Girish Chandra Chaturvedi, this is clear, friends. Now, friends, private lender ICICI Bank has received an RBI's approval for reappointment of Girish Chandra Chaturvedi as its part-time chairman for 3 years. And here is its image. Now, next question. Researcher friends from which of the following institutes have found a way in detecting tropical cyclone in North Indian Ocean earlier than satellite friends? So the right answer to this question is your IIT Kharagpur. Okay, well, before we discuss about this news, let's discuss about IIT Guwahati. Friends, IIT Guwahati, we have discussed that recently IIT Guwahati has launched a smart window, which is basically an automatic climate control. It contains a material which will automatically control the climate within the buildings. Now, friends, here it is IIT Ropar. And I hope you remember about Fake Buster. I have discussed that IIT Ropar has recently, discovered Fake Buster to detect imposters, friends, attending virtual conference. We have discussed this. Now, it's time to revise about IIT Kharagpur. Now, researchers of Indian Institute of Technology, IIT Kharagpur, friends, okay, have developed a technique, friends, and with the help of this technique, they will, detect and the development or strengthening of a tropical cyclone over an ocean of North Indian Ocean region before the satellite. Okay, it can give information about cyclone before the information is given by a satellite, friends. This is in research done by the researchers present in IIT Kharagpur. Now, the name of the researchers is Gia Albert, Vishnupriya Sahu and your Prashad K. Bhaskaran from IIT Kharagpur, who have discovered this technique, and they have used eddy detection technique to investigate the stages of advanced detection time of this tropical cyclones in India. I hope, friends, all these things are clear. You have to remember the name of IIT Kharagpur and what they have developed. Done. So next question, friends. Who has been appointed as the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court? Now, friends, who has been appointed as the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court? Option number D, Sanjay Yadav, is the right answer to this question. Now, it's time to play with the option. Vikas Behal is given here and he has been appointed as the additional judge of your Punjab and Haryana High Court. I hope, friends, you remember this. We have discussed in the previous video. Padma Kumar M. Nair is also present in the option, friends. And I hope you remember about him that he has been appointed as the CEO of your National Asset Reconstruction Company. This also I have discussed with you in the previous video. This is the method how will we keep on revising all the previous appointments also to make you remember everything. Done. Let's discuss about the news, friends. The President of India, in the exercise of Clause 1, Article 217, friends, has appointed Justice Sanjay Yadav as the judge of Allahabad High Court to be the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court. Okay, I hope clear it is, friends. So let's move forward and see question number 6. UNGCA, friends, United Nations General Assembly is president. Now, I hope you remember that we have discussed in the previous video, Abdullah Shahid. He is the foreign minister of Maldives. I hope you remember. And Maldives' capital is Male, friends. We have discussed this. And India and Maldives have signed an MOU on your, sustainable urban development. I hope you remember this also. Now, the foreign minister of Maldives, that is Abdullah Shahid, has been appointed as the 76th, for the 76th session of your United Nations General Assembly. He has been appointed as the president of 76th session of United Nations General Assembly. This news we have discussed in previous video. Now friends, the UNGC's president Abdullah Shahid has appointed Dash as the chef de cabinet. So the right answer to this question is option number D, friends. Here it is option number D. So option number D is the right answer. That is K. Nagaraj Naidu has been appointed as the chef de cabinet by Abdullah Shahid, who has been elected as the president of 76th session of United Nations General Assembly. Now, friends, now it's time to play with the option. Now let's discuss about Arun Kumar Mishra. Arun Kumar Mishra has been appointed as the chairperson of National Human Rights Commission. Friends, we have discussed this. If I talk about Chandrasekhar Ghosh, he has been appointed as the MD and CEO of Bandhan Bank. Friends, I have discussed this in the previous video only about the Bandhan Bank. Chandrasekhar Ghosh has been appointed as the MD and CEO of Bandhan Bank. If I talk about Ram Prasad Siridharan, friends, we have discussed this also. He has been appointed as the CEO and MD of your Benetton India. I hope you remember this. And now, last one is Rajesh Pandekar. Your Rajesh Pandekar has been appointed as the Director General Naval Operation, friends, in Indian Navy. I hope, friends, all these things are clear, all these appointments are clear to you. And option number D, that is K, Nagaraj Naidu, is the right answer to this question. Now, President-elect of 76th session of United Nations General Assembly, that is Maldivian Foreign Minister named Abdullah Shahid, friends, has appointed your K. Nagaraj Naidu as the chef de cabinet. I hope, friends, this news is clear. He also appointed Ambassador Thelmisa Hussein as the special envoy of PGA. Hussein is a permanent representative of Maldives, friends, to United Nations Ambassador to United States. I hope this is clear, friends. Basically, you have to remember the name, that is K. Nagaraj Naidu, who has been appointed as chef de cabinet by whom? By the president of 76th session of United General Assembly, that is Maldivian's foreign minister Abdullah Shahid. Both these names are really very, very important, and we'll be learning all these in the form of next questions options. Okay, don't worry, I'll make you remember this. RBI has hiked, friends, ATM interchange fee per transaction from rupees 15 to, and friends, it has hiked the amount from rupees 15 to rupees 17. Okay, so let's discuss what about the news. Now, friends, I hope you know this. Now, let's discuss what the news says, friends. RBI, Reserve Bank of India, has increased the interchange fee structure ATM transaction almost after 9 years, friends. Okay. And now, friends, RBI has hiked the interchange fee structure transaction from rupees 15 to rupees 17 for your financial transaction, and rupees 5 to rupees 6 for your non-financial transaction in all the centers, and it will be implemented, it will be effective by August 1, 2021. Now, friends, now I hope you know about this. Like, suppose I am a member, you know, I am a customer of SBI Bank. And suppose I have to take out money from HDFC Bank. Okay, so transaction fees has been hired in this case. I hope this is clear to you. Now I'll explain it in more detail, friends, that RBI has announced that customers are eligible for 5 free transactions, friends, which includes financial and your non-financial transaction every month. Okay, from their own bank ATM. Suppose I am a customer of SBI, from my SBI bank ATM, I am, you know, eligible for 5 free transactions, friends, including financial and non-financial transaction every month. Done. And friends, 3 free transactions, both financial and non-financial, from other banks ATM in metro city. Now in the metro cities, friends, if I am a customer of ATM, SBI, right, and I don't have, you know, nearby ATM of SBI, then I can take out money from any of the ATMs and will be given 3 free transactions in that case. Then, friends, and if I talk about non-metro centers customers, then they are given, friends, 5 transactions, financial and non-financial, from other bank ATM. Beyond the prescribed number of free transaction, friends, because if customer is eligible to form another bank ATM currently will be charged currently they are charged rupees 20 and now friends they will be charged rupees 21 in that case if they cross the limit of these free transaction from January 1, 2022. I hope the news is clear to you that the amount of interchange fee transaction has been raised from 15 to rupees 70. Clear friends? So your next question number 8. Who among the following has been appointed as the Chief Information Officer of Wipro, friends? Now, the Chief Information Officer of Wipro has been appointed, that is Anoop Purohit. Option number E is the right answer to this question. Now, friends, M.R. Kumar is present here and he has been reappointed as the Chairman of your LIC. We have discussed in the previous video. Josh De Kathur has been appointed as the Executive Director of RBI. I have discussed this also. T. Ravi Shankar has been appointed as the 4th Deputy Governor of RBI and Narendra Batra, friends, has been appointed as the President of International Hockey Federation. The CEO of International Hockey Federation is Thierry Wales and the headquarters are in Switzerland. It was founded on 7th of January 1924 in your Paris, France and related to France, India, France bilateral exercise named Varuna and this Varuna 2021 recently took place in the Arabian Sea. I hope you remember all these things, all these connections. So, IIT major Wipro friends has appointed Yes Bank executive Anoop Purohit as its Chief Information Officer. Headquarters of your Wipro are present in Bangalore. And if I talk about the name of the CEO, that is your Thierry Delaporte. Now, friends, with Bangalore, I remember the headquarters of ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, is also present in Bangalore. And the chairman of ISRO is Dr. K. Sivan. Friends, remember his name also can be asked in your examination. Now, next is friends, Buddha Dev Das Gupta, friends, passed away. He belonged to which of the following profession, friends? He was a director. Now, National Award winning filmmaker, Buddha Dev Das Gupta, friends, passed away. He received a National Film Awards in, for very multiple categories, that is best film, best director, your best screenplay and best feature films in Bengali. Okay, friends. So, your next question number 10. Indian Council of Medical Research, friends, ICMR, has approved self-use rapid antigen test kit for COVID-19, that is COVIFINE. This kit has been developed by which of the following organization? So, you have to tell the name of the organization and the right answer to this question is option number C, that is Merrill Diagnostics is the right answer. Now, friends, we're gonna play with the option as usual. Now, if I talk about Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Services, I hope you remember that recently they have developed and a medicine for COVID, that is 2DG, 2-deoxy-D-glucose. I have taught you this, we have discussed this in the news also. Now, friends, this vaccine will come in a sachet form. Obviously, we can take it orally. Basically, the work of this vaccine is to reduce the supplementary need of oxygen. Right. Now, what this vaccine gonna do, what this medicine gonna do is basically, friends, they will collect all the infected cells by COVID in one place of a body and stop the energy and growth of them. Okay. Now, next is friends, Sri Chitral Trivandrum Institute of Medical Sciences and Technology. I hope you remember about this also. We have discussed many of time, friends. Sri Chitral Trivandrum Institute of Medical Sciences has developed, friends, an RT-PCR kit to detect the multiple mutant strains of coronavirus. Okay. Now, next is friends, Breath Applied Sciences. I hope you remember about this also. It has received a national award from your Technology Development Board for conversion of carbon dioxide to your methanol and to other fuels. I hope, friends, you remember all these things regarded to these options. We'll be keep on revising these stuffs again and again so that we are able to learn it. So, friends, let's discuss what the news says. Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, friends, has approved Merrill Diagnostics self-used rapid antigen test kit for COVID-19. The name of this kit is COVIFINE. Okay. Person can self-test about the infected COVID-19. I hope, friends, this much is clear. The name is very important. That is Merrill Diagnostics. Now, friends, it's time to revise the days again. Obviously, we have to do this drill, practice this drill in every video. World Milk Day, friends. was observed on June 1, 2021. Sustainability in the dairy sector, along with empowering the environment, nutrition and socioeconomics was its theme. Next is, friends, on June 1, Global Day of Parents was also observed. Now, on 2nd of June, your Telangana Foundation Day is observed. Your 3rd of June, your World Bicycle Day is observed on 3rd June. If we talk about 4th June, then International Day of Innocent Children Victim of Aggression is observed on 4th June. On 5th June, friends, your World Environment Day is observed. And if I talk about UN decade theme for 2021 to 2030, that is ecosystem restoration. And the theme for 2021 is reimagine, recreate and restore. Now next, 7th June, friends, World Food Safety Day was observed. Safety food today for a healthy tomorrow is the theme for the year 2021. Next, friends, on 8th of June, World Ocean Day is observed with the theme The Ocean, Life and Livelihoods. And friends, on 8th of June, same, your World Brain Tumor Day is also observed. Now, revision test, friends, Antonio Guterres has appointed Daesh as the UN humanitarian chief. Your second question is, Daesh has overtaken Lionel Messi to become the second highest international goal scorer. I request everybody to please participate in this homework question, in homework drills. It is just made for your revision, friends. Okay, so please, everybody is requested to answer this question in the homework video. And if you like the video, do hit the like button. Thank you so much, friends. Thanks for watching. And I see you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.